I'm back. Hello, I've missed my ladies. It's like a reunion of the bitches. It's the bitch fiesta. I apologize in advance for the Humpty dance to be playing in the background downstairs. My husband's downstairs teaching kickboxing and his playlist is just something else, let me tell you. So I'm excited for tonight because this weekend is the worm moon. Some people call it the sugar moon. Some people call it the sap moon. There's a bunch of different names for it. They call it the sugar and the sap moon because this is the time up here where they tap the maple trees for maple syrup. But in Native American culture, they call the moon of this month the worm moon because it's when the ground starts to thaw and soften and all little worms come up and all the birds get super excited, right? They're like, oh, yummy food, right? I don't know where you live, but where I am, it has been kind of nice today. And you hear, you know, the birds are chirping and it's just a really good thing. Because let me tell you, when I was in Mexico, it was 85 degrees every day. We didn't have a drop of rain. And I was like, please, baby Jesus in a tuxedo t-shirt, do not let me go back to New Hampshire and have like a blizzard. And we're looking good. We're looking good. So I'm excited. But the worm moon is really kind of the doorway to the spring equinox. It's the doorway to Ostar, which is like the old pagan word for Easter, that the Christians stole from the pagans. And they were like, we got to make some Easter happen so we can kind of take the paganism out of this time of year. But this is all about fertility and growth and new beginnings and all that good stuff. So what's really cool about the moon this weekend is it's in Virgo. My husband's a Virgo. I don't know if there's any Virgos here. I appreciate a good Virgo. I'm not going to lie. I appreciate a good Virgo. They are pragmatic. They're very organized. They're very like attention oriented, like attention to detail. And that's what the whole energy is happening with this moon. So we're going to talk a lot about the energies coming in for this moon so that each and every one of you, including myself, can really sit down and say like, okay, what do I desire for the next 28 days of this lunar cycle? So we're going to talk a little bit about that. I'm going to open up the conversation. And then what I want to do at the end, sorry, I've been in a full day immersion. So I've been talking for 8 hours straight today, a business coaching session. So my voice is like on its last leg, hold on. And then I want to do some sound healing because I just love it. It's just such a great time before the new moon to get some sound healing in. So first of all, no one's in the chat yet. So hello, everybody. If you want to type in the chat, you're more than welcome. The first question is, did you miss me? I know that I pre-recorded all of my videos so that I didn't have to stress out when I was on vacation and be like, oh, I'm drinking tequila. Let me go and get on a live right now and teach these girls stuff. I didn't think that was a very good idea. But the first question is, did you miss me? I missed all of you. Even though I was on the app just checking on the conversations and stuff, but I didn't want to, you know, be on any social media at all. If you guys haven't noticed, only you guys know this about me, but everyone but you guys think that I'm still in Mexico because I never, ever, when I go away, I never post on my social media in real time. I have like a fear, like someone's going to come and like steal all of my underwear and sell it on the internet when I'm away, which good luck. There's like moths flying out of them. But everyone here knows that I got home. Let me say, I think I got home this last Thursday. And then I just started, Kayla goes, I was expecting you to be in a hotel. No, babe. I've been home since Thursday night. And then as soon as I got home, I started posting as if I was in vacation mode. So everyone's like, oh my God, you're so lucky to be there. And I'm like, I'm actually in Windham, New Hampshire right now, freezing my titties off, but you don't have to know that because you're not my people. Jessica, I was going through withdrawals. Yes. I was like really missing you guys too. But I know that Kim was holding down the fort, and I know that you had, all of you had your work cut out for you with all of the information that I dropped last week. How cute is Tyrus, my hairstylist? Is he not adorable? Did you guys watch the video? And then also Victoria. And how adorable is freaking Ginny? Like, she is just the cutest thing that ever happened since sliced bread. This Friday, guys, not to go off tangent, but this Friday, my dream interpreter, her name is Krista Stanley. She's one of the top dream chiromancers in the whole entire world. She's going to be dropping her video this Friday, and you guys, it's going to blow your socks off. So get freaking ready for that. A tequila live would have been hilarious. You know what's really funny? I never really got drunk in Mexico. It was like the weirdest thing. Like, I wanted to get drunk. I was like, I'm going to rage. And then I would have like a couple glasses of tequila, and I was just like so relaxed that I would just like go to bed at 8 o'clock at night. I'm not even trying to be cute. Literally, I was in bed every day at like 8 o'clock at night. I was not. Matt and I were like with all the old folks at like 4 o'clock having like early dinner. Kelly, you know I love a 4 o'clock dinner. Okay. Jess says, I use something called Malibu to get hard water minerals out of my hair. Yeah, that's what I use too. And that's what Tyrus turned me on to. And I always just thought I had like shitty hair until like Tyrus turned me on to this. I'm like, oh, I actually have nice hair. Same on dinner at four. Kelly says, absolutely. Absolutely. I know that some of you guys were talking about how you were buying stuff from Tyrus. I didn't even know he was doing that. So that's awesome. I guess he'll ship you whatever you need, which is really cool. Does anybody have any questions from the last couple of weeks that I've been away? Comments, questions, anything? Like, I'm open to all of it. I saw a lot of you guys having trouble with my shamans, the Caballarian stuff, like doing the math and stuff. I'm just wondering if like everybody got that all situated. And if you need anything, let me know. I'll look in the chats. No questions, huh? Okay, let's get down and dirty. Please ask questions though in the meantime if you do have a question. Okay. So the energies that are coming in for this moon in Virgo, the warm moon, is it's all about, how can I put this? Because I channeled this at like five o'clock this morning. It's all about cleaning and organizing and rearranging, but not just like your physical three-dimensional reality, also like your spirituality, your habits, your rituals, the people in your life, what is and what isn't, is no longer serving you. So it's really all about getting organized and very like rearranging all that stuff. Is anyone feeling that energy right now? Like they just like want to do like a clean sweep of life. Kayla, like a couple of weeks ago, I think it was Kayla. She posted a meme on Instagram that was saying like, you have one nice spring day and you feel like you got to pop Molly. Was it you, Kayla, that you posted that? Yeah. And as soon as you have a little sunshine on your face, you're like, all of a sudden you turn into like Jersey Shore circa, like beat that beat up, right? Like you just want to like do all the things, like it really motivates you. And in the spiritual calendar, this time, spring equinox, austere, is the time that we all come out of the slumber, right? Because when you're in the winter solstice and when you're in those winter months, because we are animals, we are supposed to be hibernating. We're supposed to be doing all this self-care. We're supposed to be kind of like going into our cave, not only in a physical sense, but, you know, a figurative sense, right? Like I'm going within, I'm going to like take consensus of the last year and like see what's working, what's no longer working and protecting myself and all that kind of stuff. So the spring equinox is like when you get like pumped, you're like, okay, it's ready to like make some moves, right? We're like ready to get out there. We're ready to start moving and shaking. So if you're feeling like that right now, that is really good. That means that you're connecting to that energy of what's happening in our universe, right? Because we are, like Carl Sagan once said, we are made of stardust. We are the cosmos, and the cosmos is within us, and we are within it. So when things are happening astrologically and energetically, like we are going to feel those things. So if you're feeling like cleaning out some of the bullshit, that means that you're really on point with what's going on in the universe. Susan says, yes, I am. Oh my God, Kelly, no, I can't handle this. Hold on. Let me go back for a second. Fuck, I saw that. I was like, and it's going to fucking flip out. Oh my God. So let me see here. Okay, so Christina's feeling it. Jess is feeling it. Brittany says, I just consigned more than half my closet. I plan to keep going. Doesn't it feel so fucking good? Like, it feels so fucking good. Like, just getting rid of anything, like, even if it's like nice stuff, like if it's not your vibe anymore, like, let it go. Like, let yourself. It was funny because at the hotel that we were staying at, it's a Mayan hotel. And every day they would push this little thing under your door about the spiritual aspects of the day. Swear to God. Like, it was just like, oh my God, I like manifested this fucking hotel. And one day it was like, today is the day of the white snake, not like white snake, like the band, but like the white snake in Mayan culture, like not Tawny Katane on the front of the, you know what I'm saying? And they were saying like, the energy of today is that we must shed the old skin so that we can kind of step into that new skin. And I was already feeling that energy when I was out there. So I was aware that it was the Virgo moon and I was aware of the energies, but I wasn't really like knee deep in it. And I was feeling that. So when I came home and I was like, oh, okay, today, this weekend's the Virgo moon. Like, this all makes sense. This is all about like the shedding and letting go of the old skin, because so many of us, including myself, we're dragging around the old versions of ourselves, if you will. Like, we might bury them down a little bit because we don't want people to see them, but we still are carrying them around. So it's really like, it's a time right now, especially during this full moon, to release and surrender to any of the things, people, places, experiences, whatever, that is holding you back from your highest, greatest good. So Brittany's doing it in the consignment realm, right? Like, she's like, I don't need these clothes. Like, they're cute, but like, I don't know, it's not me anymore. Or like, maybe I don't like them anymore. And like, it will probably be better for someone else. And I always tell people, you can't have more in your life if you're holding on to the old, because it's blocking your blessings from coming in, right? So like, I have so many clients that like have like, they're younger, you know, and they have like relationship issues with like boyfriends and stuff. And they come to me for a healing session. They're like, I know that he's not the one, but like, I don't want to be lonely. So I'm just going to keep him around until I find the one. And I'm like, bitch, that's not how it works. You have to let that go. So it makes the room for the new person to come in, you know? So like, wake up and smell the poontang, as little Wayne would say. Kelly says, been totally feeling that. I want to redo my whole house. God, I'm so afraid for this conversation, Kelly. Jesus. Yeah. And I also think many of us, including myself, our reticular activating systems in our brain are like working overtime because we have all, I mean, can we just like take a moment of silence to say, 2 years ago, like, we were stepping into the week before shit hit the fan. Like, none of us here, including myself, knew that we were going to be like fucking in lockdown almost for 2 years, right? So what happens is we're in our homes so much that our reticular activating system, the part of our brain that's like, that needs to go, this needs to change, I'm bored with that, blah, blah, blah. It's like working overtime because, and that's what I said to Matt. I go, if we don't get the fuck out of this house, like, I'm going to freak out. And that's why we ended up booking to go away, because it wasn't that I don't have a beautiful home, but I started doing the same thing, Kelly. I was like, we need a new this. And why is this like that? And then he was just like, whoa, okay. Like, but it, I know you're probably feeling that because it's like the energy is moving, but it's also our reticular activating systems in our brain are like working way, way, way too hard right now, because we've literally been staring at the same four walls for the last 2 years of our lives, right? Sandra says, yes, I'm planning on painting my bathroom, the cabinets, and my bedroom. Plus, I'm leaving my job on Friday. Congratulations. I'm so proud of you. Lots of purging and lots of changing. I love it. So we're all so proud of you. And Susan says, yes, I am. And Brittany also says, also getting rid of people who don't serve me. Been feeling that for a while. And you know, to Brittany's, to kind of pontificate on what Brittany's saying is like, it doesn't have to be a knockdown, drag out fight, right? It could just literally be like you making a little bit more space in between the text messages or the calls or the seeing of each other. And then if it's not meant for you, it will just naturally dissipate. I think that we think like as bad bitches that we're going to be like, yo, we got to tell that bitch to go fuck herself, cause she's like not as high vibe as me and fuck her and all this shit. And like, I get like that sometimes too. But at the end of the day, like rejection is spirit's protection. So when you start to put a little bit of space in between you and those people, if it's not meant for you, God will just remove those people from your life and it won't have to be a big brouhaha, you know? Kayla says, I was cleaning my apartment like a mad woman today. Yeah, I did that. What is today? Today is Tuesday. I did it on Sunday. I was like a maniac and I was just like, woo! And it just feels good to wake up to a clean space. You know, I always say like, you know, when your house is cluttered, your mind is cluttered and your energetic vibrational frequency is cluttered. And sometimes it's just the best thing to just be like, you know what? Mom is just going to put on some good tunes and she's going to jam out with her clam out and rock out with her cock out. And she's going to clean the damn house. And it feels good. You know, it really does. Jess says, my ritual the past month or so, I've been doing gratitude in my ambitious abundance affirmation every morning and night from memory in bed. And it has really made a difference in setting intentions for the day. That makes me so happy. When people tell me that they're doing their ambitious abundance affirmation from by heart, like I get juicy and wet. Cause I'm like, yes, that means you're just doing the damn thing. Christina says, same Brittany. It feels so good to get rid of toxic people. Just not, it's not healthy and it's not serving anyone. It really isn't. And guess what? It's actually not serving the toxic people for you keeping them around because it's actually keeping them in the hypnotic rhythm as well, right? Kayla says, totally feeling that energy, snake shedding its skin. Yeah, 100%. And it's so funny too, because Kim called me the other day and she's like, I had a dream about snakes. And then Aubrey had inboxed me on the app and she's like, I had a dream about snakes in my boots. What the hell does this mean? And then I bought a rug for my podcast room. That's a big black snake. And I'm like, what is going on? And then all of a sudden, these are the energies. So nothing is coincidental. Nothing is coincidental. Jess says, oh my God, speaking of old skin, I did one of those baby feet foot masks and my feet are shedding. Oh my God. Can we just talk about that? That shit is so fucking crazy because it literally peels off. I have like a foot fetish where I only can let someone else do that stuff to me because in like 2002, I got hammered. Remember when Ped Egg came out? Do you remember the Ped Egg? It was like a little egg and it like you could shave like grate your cheesy feet. And I was like so smashed one night and I was like watching like Real Housewives of New Jersey and I was just like drunk and I was just like pet egging my feet. And then I went to bed, I passed out, AKA went to bed. And the next morning I woke up and I put my feet on the ground and I screamed bloody murder because my feet were like raw hamburger. And I had to put like 50 pounds of Vaseline and then wrap my feet in Saran wrap and then put like 7 pairs of socks on just to go to work and train my clients. Cause I had like bloody nubs. So anything with the feet freaks me out. I have like hashtag PTSD. Oh my God. But it works, dude. Those things work. Oh my God. Isn't this crazy, Jess, to think about this? Like 2 years ago, your school closed down. We had our last, I just saw that picture in my phone. I was like looking for a picture and I was like, oh my God, we were all in our ambitious sweatshirts together. Remember? And then literally that was that weekend and we closed down that Monday. Like everything closed down. Like little did we know that was the last time we were going to be like normal hoes. Oh, it's so crazy. Oh, thank you. My nails are gorge, right? I know. I'm getting them done on Friday. One of them flew off in the pool in Mexico when I was like pulling my bathing suit up and it like went across the pool. So when I came home, I took it and I put it in my purse and I made my nail lady put it back on with glue. And she's like, this is the most ghetto thing I've ever seen in my life. And I'm like, I never said I wasn't ghetto, bitch. I never said I wasn't ghetto. Just put some, I was going to super glue it, but she said that would be bad. Lisa says, I'm remodeling one of my rooms to an office instead of working from home in my kitchen. It's time for me. Absolutely. And by the way, if Ginny was here and she heard that you were working in your kitchen, she would say that that is bad feng shui, because you, everything in your house has to have a designated area. Okay. So that's why when people watch TV and eat, like, no, like it's the same exact thing. So when you actually remodel your home office to a real home office and you get out of the kitchen, you're going to feel so much better, so much lighter, and so much happier working than you were before in your kitchen. Okay. So what should we be doing right now? Okay. I would really like for you to take the next, you know, think, so the lunar cycle from full moon to full moon is 28 days, correct? So what I would like for you guys to do, and if you have, you know, a notebook or a journal or a paper, you can write this down. If not, you can come back and watch it again or whatever. It does not matter to me. But what I would like for you to do is take the next 28 days and start slowly. Because remember, Virgos, because with the moon is in Virgo, right? Virgos are very methodical and they're very pragmatic. So they're very methodical and they're very pragmatic. Virgos are never going to fly by the seat of their pants. Like my husband's a Virgo. He has to know like every move that you make, every moment. It's so fucking annoying. And I'm an Aquarius. So I'm like, literally falling from the sky. Like, I don't even know what's happening, but I'm just going with the flow. Like I just, that's how I roll, which is good that I'm an Aquarius and he's a Virgo. Cause we balance each other out. You know, like I lift him up. And he like kind of, okay, you need to simmer the fuck down, take a seat. You're being really fucking crazy. And he is the one that kind of like makes me simmer. But the Virgos are never, ever, ever, ever going to do anything that's flying by the seat of their pants. So am I telling you like tomorrow, rip your whole entire house to shreds? And no, I'm telling you like every day for the next 28 days, like pick a drawer. Like go in your kitchen, pick a drawer, be like, okay, today I'm going to go through the drawer of utensils in my kitchen. Do I really need 72 different spatulas? Probably not. Right. And really streamline. And then the next drawer could be, you know, the junk drawer. Y'all, I'm sure everyone here, including myself, actually, I don't have a junk drawer. It's my husband's junk drawer. And I just make it my junk drawer because I just throw shit in there because it's disgusting. But he has this one drawer in the kitchen and it's always like shit's like piling out of it. And I get so angry at him. And then like one day it will just be clean. Cause that's also how Virgos are. They're very fucking stubborn. And if you're like, hey, clean your drawer, clean your drawer, clean your drawer. They're going to be like, fuck you. I'll do what I want. And then all of a sudden one day when I'm not saying it to him, he cleans his drawer because in his mind, he says he thinks that he made the decision to clean the drawer, right? So that's, it's all like this power thing. So being very methodical and very pragmatic, okay? So go through one drawer a day or look at your house and say like, what is the thing in my home that is cluttering the energy? So I want to know, do you guys, does anybody have a something in their home that's like, you know, like the room of requirement from Harry Potter. Do you guys know what the room of requirement is? Like when they just like throw all the old like magic spells that don't work anymore, you know, they throw them in that room. What is in your house that you know for a fact that is clogging your energy? I want to know in the chat. And Rita says, my entire family is Virgos and I hate it. It's so hard. Well, you're also an Aquarius like me. So obviously no wonder. Jess, what is your sign? I don't have a junk drawer. I love to organize and I can't stand clutter. Me neither. Okay. So Sandra's saying her craft and office room is like, ooh, oh, okay. Yeah. That makes sense. You being a Cancer. Absolutely. They like organization and Cancers are all about the home, right? They're the crab and they're like, I'm going to go in my little home now, in my little shell. They love that. So that's why, you know, Cancers are really super organized. My niece is a Cancer and literally when you go, cause she has her bedroom at my house that she just like stores, like she just brings like all this shit over and she just like has it all like lined up. And she only comes over like once a month now, but she has like half of her wardrobe at my house and she's got all her little things. It's like so perfect. my basement and Ed's office. Why does it always have to be the guy's office? So I did a stupid thing when we moved into our house where I was in love with this restoration hardware, 17th century French writing desk. And it's a double writing desk. So if like literally four people can sit at this desk at once, but I have like a chair for Matt and a chair for me. And I thought, like, wouldn't it be so cute if we were like working together downstairs? Wouldn't it be so fun? Bitch, no. If you ever come in my house, which a lot of you guys have seen it, my big French writing desk, like my side of the desk is like perfectly pristine with like all my crystals and all my things and everything is perfect. And Matt's shit is like, it makes me wanna fucking take his penis and tie it in a bow and just kill him, because I like organization. Because for me, if like I'm trying to work and I'm sitting around a lot of papers and all that shit, it makes me mental. And the basement is also always a bone of contention, isn't it? It's like the basement in Home Alone when you go downstairs and the thing opens. Oh, it's like always. Lisa's saying my storage room in the basement. Oh, I did my storage room in the basement like a year and a half ago, and it like changed my life. Changed my life. But he says, I just got rid of so much shit. If I get rid of any more, I'll be naked sitting on the floor. Welcome to a hardcore spiritual awakening. Because this is what happened to me when I went through my really hardcore spiritual awakening. I became like a fucking minimalist. And Matt was like getting afraid because I had like one spoon, one knife, and like a bowl. I was like a monk living in a monastery. And now I have things, but the things that I have are actually more meaningful to me in my house than the shit that I had before, right? Christina's saying my basement. Just saying my business room with all my filming stuff and postmark. Yeah. The filming room always gets a little funky, you know, like if you're not on top of it, like, you know, I do the same thing as you where I have all the things and I'm always doing reels and all this stuff, and it can get a lot. And then you don't feel creative because the space is kind of cluttery, you know. Kayla says my kitchen table and my dresser are clutter collectors. Yep. And you kind of have to, and like, you know, when you have a home and you're living, obviously not alone, right? You have a baby and you have your husband and a dog. I kind of have to make rules with Matt. Like when you come home, stop putting your shit here. Cause that's what Matt will do. You know, I'll like, for him, it's the kitchen counter in our island. Like he'll come home and he'll like empty his pockets and throw all the mail and all this shit. And I'm like, no, do not do that. Put it in your little junk drawer. And Brittany goes, quite literally every room in the house. But you just go through one at a time, right? One at a time, be that Virgo, be pragmatic. Attention to the details, right? Kelly says, I want to throw a grenade in there. Oh, wouldn't that just be so fun to do? I feel the same way about certain things too. Aileen says, my closet, but it's under construction now and I will be purging, have so many clothes and jewelry just taking real estate. Yep. And remember, like if you read the book Ambitious, like get on Poshmark, right? Like I actually had posted, and I never did it because I ended up having so much work to do and going to Mexico, but I have tens of thousands of clothes from Lululemon that have literally been worn once for a photo shoot, once for an appearance, like once for this thing, and never like worked out in it a day in my life. And it's just like sitting in my closet and I'm like, what the fuck am I doing? That like, this is not even, it's super cute clothes, but it's just not my style anymore. And I was thinking, you know, like we should have like a little, almost like, you know, like a little marketplace in Ambitious Academy where we can have like one thread and like, you guys can just sell and trade and barter your shit with each other. Like, why the fuck not? You know, someone's trash is another person's treasure. That's what I heard. Someone really smart said that once. Kayla goes, me too, Katie. I have no fucking clothes. I gave everything away because I didn't like anything. Right. Because as you spiritually evolve, the old way that you used to dress, because even though it's a three-dimensional construct, it still is like your personality and your energetic vibrational frequency coming through. So like I look at clothes that I used to wear, you know, like 5 years ago, and I'm like, oh my God, this is so not even who I am anymore, you know, and that's okay. And when you figure it out, you'll get new stuff and it will be quality stuff that is not just taking up space, and you're not going to just buy, you're going to say, okay, like for me, capsule wardrobing is like the best thing ever. Like, it's changed my life. And that's maybe what you might want to do down the road. Jess goes, all this talk is making me want to organize everything again. Yeah, it's a sickness. Jess says, for anyone needing help organizing or cleaning out, Erin Condolaro is great. She does virtual sessions. I did one with her and she helped me out a lot in a very short time. Erin's awesome. Erin's really good at that. Because a lot of people don't even know how to start. You know, they like look at something and they're like, oh my God. And they just get overwhelmed. And then they just like, don't want to do anything, you know? Aileen says, I used to work at a boutique and bought so much stuff I never wore. Mm-hmm. Yeah. When I was a freshman in college, I had like a little part-time job at Express. You guys know what I'm talking about? In the mall. And I used to buy every penny that I made would go to buy fucking clothes. And that was like just to wear to work, to go try to make more money, to have to buy more clothes. Like, what the fuck was I doing? I think about that sometimes. I'm like, not good. So I want you guys to use the next 28 days to clear and clean and organize and rearrange, right? And plan and prepare. And while you're doing it, focus on the details. And get in that motivated energy of the spring. Like, this is the time, right? This is the time to get that motivation. This is in college. I had 10 pairs of black pants. Remember when black work pants were club clothes? They go from day to night, honey. Remember the ones from Express that like had like the little, they were flares and then they had like the little cuts in the side. Oh, girl. And I would wear my little cami with a little shrug. A little shrug over it. There are some really funny Instagram accounts. Jess, I actually think you posted something from one of the girls the other day that she always talks about the early 2000s. And like, she does, what were we fucking doing and wearing? And oy, 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 I can't even, I had like, stock in, remember baby fat clothes? Oh my God. I had every Juicy Couture velour tracksuit that in every fucking color. I'm telling you, don't tempt me with a little Stoli Raz and some soda water with a twist of lime and my black Express flare pants. Chargo's baby fat was my ish. Of course, because you're a Portuguese just like me and we love that shit. We just love the more ghetto, the better. As we say in Massachusetts. Oh my God. I'm pissing my pants for laughing right now with my Steve Madden heels. Mm-hmm. And you know, those fuckers are coming back. The ones that were like the platform thong sandals. I saw a little girl wearing like, you know, a younger kid, like 19 years old wearing it the other day. And I was like, you fuck. Like, what are you doing? I threw those in the trash a long time ago. Now they're coming back. Aileen goes, St. Patty's Day, 1998. It was in a green suit and I did the walk of shame the next morning. Oh yeah. Same. You know, those are coming back too. Did you see Kim Kardashian and freaking Paris Hilton was wearing them like just recently? I'm like, okay. Like my mother always said, don't throw things away because it always comes back in style. No wonder why I was a hoarder before I had a spiritual awakening. Kid goes, I bought my daughter a Juicy tracksuit. Haha, I had to do it. It was so cute. Oh my God. They're adorable and so comfortable. So freaking comfortable. Kelly says, I just cleaned and organized my garage and it makes me so happy every time I walk in the house. Right? Like it just feels so good. You know, we've been doing this backyard project with our little backyard trolls that never show up to work anymore because it's been snowing or whatever. But in the fall, they told us, you know, like, oh, it's going to be a 3-week project. And now we're going on like 7 months and, you know, whatever. I'm not hurt or aggravated or anything, but we have so much shit in our garage right now because we have like the television and all the outdoor furniture and like all this crap. And it makes me mental. Every time I get out of my Range Rover, I either hit something in front of me or I open the door and hit something. I'm like, what is this peasant life that I'm living? This is not fucking good. When I get out of my fucking Range Rover, I don't want to be hitting shit because I'm supposed to be a rich bitch, not a peasant that fucking bangs into stuff in my garage. Kelly, those motherfuckers don't get out over my house soon. They're going to be wearing Italian neckties, if you know what I mean. Kayla says, ghetto fab, Massachusetts bitch forever. And don't let me forget about my big earrings, my big hoops, because you know what they say? The bigger the O, the bigger the hoe. I took mine out a little while ago. They were aggravating my ears. Lizzie says, the chunky heels in Catholic school with our skirts, those shoes are back. It's fucked up. Like platform penny loafers. That is all the rage right now. Versace, if you look at Versace's website, it's all the shit that I used to wear in like eighth grade. And I swore I would never wear again. And it's all coming back. It's so crazy. So am I speaking your language right now? Am I like, are you resonating with what I'm saying? The other thing is too, is that Virgo is in the sixth house in the Zodiac. And the sixth house in the Zodiac is actually the house of routine. Okay. So the sixth house of the Zodiac is the house of routine. So what am I saying here? What I mean is if that is true, this is about looking at your routine every day and saying like, okay, where am I wasting time? Where am I giving way too many fucks? Right. What are some bad habits that I'm maybe holding on to, or even I've heard this a lot and I'm just going to throw it out there. Cause you know, I have been hearing this a lot. Like so many people have been saying to me, you know, Katie, I've been doing so well. And then all of a sudden, like the last like couple months, I've just been falling back into all these old, like bad habits and limiting self-beliefs and all this shit. So this is, if that's you, this is a really fucking good time to get rid of that. So again, take the next 28 days and maybe, you know, the next couple of days when the moon is starting to come into its fullness and say like, okay, hold the fucking mirror up to yourself, Snow White, and say, okay, what are some bad habits that I'm bringing back or I'm doing, or what are some routines or just things throughout my day, or even like people that you're hanging out with that you're just like, and you know, I'm going to just say it. People will say this to me all the time, but I've been friends with them since kindergarten. Well, guess what? The person that you were in kindergarten is not the same fucking person you are now. I mean, like, God, I hope not. So like people come into your life for a reason, a season or a lifetime, right? There's that old, like live, laugh, love, like old fucking adage. And that's true, right? Like people come into your life for a reason, a season or a lifetime. So just because you were best friends with someone in kindergarten and you're just dragging this broke ass bitch around now, but you're like, but we've been besties since kindergarten, you know, like, I don't want to hear it because it's not serving you. Like you can still be friends with them. Like I said to Brittany before, like you don't have to have a knockdown drag out brawl with these people, but you have to say to yourself like, okay, like I'll give you an example. You know, there's like that old saying that's like, if there's a circle of friends with five friends and everyone is broke, you're going to be the fifth broke person. It's the same thing with wealth and abundance and high vibrational frequency. If you're hanging out with people that are wealthy and they're hard workers and they're fucking, they care about the big picture and they're not, you know, freaking out about three-dimensional bullshit, it's going to change. The conversation there is different. Okay. The conversation there is different. Like I always talk about like how, you know, I'll go back home sometimes to visit my family. You know, I'm from Taunton, Massachusetts, and no one really down there is setting the world on fire. You know, no one I know. Okay. I'm not going to generalize, but no one I know down there is setting the world on fire. And like, I'll go down there and I'll go to like to lunch or dinner with my mom and dad. And it's like, my mom is like the mayor of Munchkin City. Like everyone knows her. So my, you know, we'll be like at dinner and people will be like, oh, Terry, oh, how's the kids? And how's this? And it's the same fucking conversation that my mother has been having with these certain people since literally the Reagan administration. Cause they're all doing the same shit. They're in hypnotic rhythm, right? Remember in Outwitting the Devil and in Think and Grow Rich, Napoleon Hill says, you know, there's even like, you know, if you're on Fifth Avenue, the energy is very different. And then you go back three or four blocks and you're in the slums and the energy is very different there. Right. So think about this. Think about what I'm saying to you right now. When you're surrounding yourself with people who are like doing big shit, doesn't it make you want to do big shit too? Right. And when you're hanging out with people that are not doing, they're literally doing the least, even though you might not be like that type of energy, it rubs off into your auric field. And if you came from that place, it's very easy to snap back into that place. It's almost like, you know, when you're like doing really well on your meal plan and you're fasting and you feel so good, and then you go hang out with like your friends that maybe you haven't seen for a long time, and they're like, come on, it's just a piece of cake. Just have the piece of cake. It's just three cosmopolitans. And they get in the, and then all of a sudden you're like, well, I guess. And then you cave. And then the next day you go, why the fuck did I do that? So even though you are a sovereign autonomous being, it's an energetic vibrational frequency that is triggered in your brain that reminds you of the old person that you used to be. And it's very easy, as we all know, to slip back into that comfortable pattern. Can I get an amen? Right? We're all human beings. It's the way it goes, right? So think about the Virgo being in the sixth house, routine, habits, right? People, old limiting self-beliefs, you know? Like just because your family was poor does not mean you're meant to be poor. You know, I see so many people that I work with and they have so much potential. And because they grew up with not a lot and very lack mindset, it's ingrained like in their fucking DNA and their grooved patterns of their brain, you know? And I think that part of your spiritual awakening is actually unlearning everything you've learned. Unfortunately, right? So take the next 28 days to clean and organize and motivate yourself and really take a hard look at your habits and your rituals and the things that you're doing on a daily basis that may be no longer serving you, but also take a look at the things that are serving you and do more of that, right? And do more of that, right? Like I love having conversations with people. I had a one-on-one with Aileen, Monday. Oh my God, what day is it? And we were just talking. And then I looked and I go, oh fuck, Aileen, I just went over almost 45 fucking minutes over what I was supposed to be doing. And she's like, oh my God, I didn't even know, like whatever. Because we're in the flow, because we're doing this shit that we love to fucking do. Now, if you put me in a room with someone who is lack mindset, limiting, all this shit, I will literally be like, where is the fucking razor blade? Let me just like end this now. Right. And it's like that with everything. Okay. And then obviously not to be like old school mundane, but you all know that in the full moon, that's when you let go of the things that you no longer serve, that no longer serve your highest, greatest good. So the best thing to do is, you know, take a piece of paper and write down, these are the things that no longer serve my highest, greatest good. And you can do it tonight, tomorrow, Friday, Saturday, Sunday, Monday, because it's a 3-day before and a 3-day after the full moon. You know, pick a night where you can actually get like really, you know, witchy and do all your little devilments, right? You can go outside and do all your stuff and read that paper out loud and say, these are the things that no longer serve my highest, greatest good, and read them out loud and say, and I let them go and release them. And so it is, and light it on fire. And the smoke and the fire will transmute that, right? Kayla says, this might be a subject for another day, but I'd love to learn some tips about navigating partners' limiting beliefs. I feel like, oh, honey, we could do a whole podcast on that, girl. It was funny because someone was asking me the other day, I don't remember who the fuck it was. I don't remember. It will come to me. Someone I was working with. Maybe it was, I don't remember. Anyways. And they were saying like, you know, they were asking me like, when you and Matt got together, and by the way, my husband and my relationship is a spiritual relationship. You know, like I love him. I think he's a cutie pie, even though I want to punch him in his fucking face sometimes for pissing all over the floor near the toilet instead of in the toilet. You know what I'm saying? But our relationship is spiritual. Like I believe that we were brought together to do really amazing, amazing stuff. And the person was saying to me, were you ever growing like at a rate that like maybe Matt wasn't growing as fast as you, or Matt was growing and you weren't? And I say, yes, abso-fucking-lutely. But, oh, Aileen, you were asking me, okay, it was in our fucking very long conversation that I lost track of time. I apologize. So Aileen was asking me this because in every relationship, no matter if your husband is the Dalai Lama, right? or like, I don't know, Deepak Chopra or some like evolved being, or if he's like, duh, like a lump on a log, okay? Everyone is going to grow at different rates spiritually. But the problem is that when two people are growing, like say like, because Kayla's asking the question. So say like Kayla's like growing and she's getting rid of these limiting self-beliefs and she's going to the next level. And maybe her husband is like having a hard time. It's okay. All you do is you just hold that space, right? You just hold that space for that person to grow. But after a while, what's going to happen is if the person is really not trying to grow, and remember, we don't dangle people, right, guys? We don't dangle. If the person is not growing with you, and I'm not condoning breaking up or getting divorced or any of that shit, I don't want that at all. But I see so many women that I work with that they are so fucking amazing, and their husbands or their boyfriends or their significant others or whatever are so far behind them, and they're so not into what they're doing, and they actually make fun of them and talk shit to them. That is not okay. It's not okay. And there might be a time in your lives, all of you, you know, with whomever you're with, that you might be like, okay, this isn't working anymore because I'm working so hard on growing and this person wants nothing to do with it. And then on top of it, he's like teasing me, making fun of me, you know, calling me a psychopath. I'm not saying calling you a psychopath, but they always call me. I'm always the sacrificial lamb. Like all the husbands hate me because they're like, you made my wife like this. And I was like, actually, I just gave her the tools. And you're a dick. So she's not bowing down and licking your booty hole anymore. Sorry. You know? So I would love to actually just do a podcast about that because Matt could put in his two cents. And I always love to get a male perspective too. Because, you know, I can be a little see you next Tuesday when it comes to this kind of stuff sometimes. But yeah. All right. Kayla goes, fuck, my phone died. I'll have to catch that. That's fine. It was brief, but it was good. Does anybody have any questions about anything before we finish up with like a brief sound healing, but something to just anchor you all down? As I drool water down my face. Aww. Kim says, my husband loves you. He always says, thank you, Katie Boyd, for finding my Kim. Makes me want to cry. Thank you. And listen, there's a lot of great men in the world. A lot of fucking great men. Oh, and I love Steve. But it's hard because, you know, I've gone like really far up in my spiritual journey. And Matt was like not having it. And y'all know Matt is like so spiritual. But, you know, we take turns. We take turns. And then there's times that I'm like, I don't want to do any of this fucking shit. And Matt's like fucking Jay Shetty. I'm like, fuck you, Matt. You and your spiritual Jay Shetty monk self. And Rita says, can you give us three big summary points? I had to join 30 minutes late. Yes. So the three big summary points are clean, organize, motivate, rearrange, do all those things to make your life just energetically more high vibrational. The second thing is to pay attention to the details. So like, don't overlook things that are important right now. Like really like read the fine print, pay attention to the details, right? And the third thing I would have to say is look over your routine and start really streamlining it. And this just getting rid of the shit that does not serve you, you know, not serve you. And then, like I said, take your journal out and really think about like, okay, where in my house, in my life, in my career, in my relationships must I clean? And the second thing, like I said, is what in my routines, my habits are out of whack and that are keeping me from leveling up. And then I would have to say, to do your full moon work around this. So I would say that those are the biggest three things to do for the next 28 days. So do your new moon work, clean and organize, And I'm looking at my notes and look at your routine and then cut ties with that shit. Brittany says, is there something I can do related to my current situation I've talked to you about? Yeah, I think, and I know that, you know, you actually talked about this on our wall. So you were getting, you know, other people's, other people's two cents and advice. I would have to say, and this is the best advice I give to myself a lot. Try to take yourself out of your body. I know this is going to be so woo-woo, but try to like remove your, you know how like when you look at something, you know, like you're looking at the shit, but it's not like your eyes, it's like the thing behind your eyes. It's your soul, right? So it's almost like you want to separate your physical body from your soul. And I actually live in this state all the time. This is just how I live. So like right now I'm talking to you all, but like my soul is over here in this corner, looking down on me doing this work. And I've been like that since I was a small child. And it's just, I don't even know if I want to come back to one piece, but it's almost like I have this like little energetic cord, you know, that keeps my soul attached to my physical body so I can do my work. So I would say step out of your physical body and look at yourself as if you are watching yourself, as if you are watching yourself in a movie, and be the star of your own movie. And every time you do something, say like, okay, what would like the highest version of Brittany do in this situation? Because I know that the highest version of all of us wouldn't be like, I fucking hate these people. They're so fucking annoying. Ah, even though it's probably fucking true, right? It's probably fucking true. But each person in our life is showing up to teach us and to help us remember who the fuck we are faster. And also, like I was saying before, to teach you like what you will not be like as a boss, or you would not be like as a coworker, right? And to not allow yourself to react, right? So if someone's trying to like whoop you up, or they're acting shady, or they're like throwing you shade, or whatever these fuckers are doing to you, like when you don't react in the same way that you used to react, that is spiritual evolution. And when you spiritually evolve, those people will fall away naturally and they won't show up anymore. And then what will happen is there'll be other people that come in that just show up in different masks, but with the same fuckery that they were doing before, but it's a test again. And then you pass the test. And then God is like, oh, that little Brittany, isn't she a cutie pie? Let's throw her a bone. And then you know what happens? That fucking lesson is over and we just move on to other things. So try to like take yourself outside of yourself and like watch yourself as if you are watching like a Netflix show, if that makes sense. Kayla says, that's something I do to edit my routine. I journal about what would the highest version of myself do in the morning? What would the highest version of myself do every day? What would wouldn't she do? 100%, right? It's like when you have those days where we all have them and you're like, I really should work out right now, but I just don't want to fucking do this. But would the highest version of Katie or Kayla or Jess or Susan or any of us say, no, I'm not going to work out? Because you know that you're working out not to be thin, but you're working out to do what? Take care of your temple. Because the longer your temple can roam this earth, the longer you can do the work that you came here to do, right? So that's a really good way to put it, Kayla. I love that. All right, want to do like just a 5-minute little sound healing, nothing cray cray, but just like, let's ground ourselves down. My lips are so dry. I just smiled and I think I just busted my lip in half. Like someone just cracked me. Okay. I should probably use some of my Victoria Duke lip gloss. That would probably help me. All right, so let's close our eyes. I'm going to bring you into my healing room where all my bowls are. So let's close our eyes. Let's just take 3 deep breaths. And I just want you to listen to the tones and just let the tones just move through you. You don't have to think of anything. You don't have to say anything. Just be present and focus on the inhalations and the exhalations. So breathing in through the nose, filling up your lungs all the way to the bottom of your belly. And then slowly breathing out. Let's take three nice deep breaths once more. Inhaling in through our noses, filling up our lungs. Exhaling all the way out. Inhale. Exhale. Last one, inhale. Exhale. Nice job. All right, so you have your work cut out for you. You have your marching orders. Let's keep the conversation going this week about all this over the next couple of days, because obviously I know not everyone can show up live. So there'll be a lot of questions, I think, going forward. So let's keep the conversation going over on the Ambitious app. And then don't forget to check out the amazing video that's coming out on Friday by Krista Stanley, my chiromancer. She is absolutely incredible. You guys are going to love it. Love it. I love each and every one of you. I'm so happy to be home. And I can't wait to see everybody in real life, hopefully soon, sooner than later, please. Before you go, don't forget, Bitchapalooza is January 6th, 7th, and 8th. Okay. So we got our DJ coming in, the food trucks, the whole nine yards. So y'all better be ready. So January 6th, 7th, and 8th of 2023, it's going to be a 3-day. That's why we're calling it Bitchapalooza for all of us oldies out there. Remember Lollapalooza? It was like an old Woodstock festival for all the grungy kids. Well, this is going to be not grungy and more bougie than that. Oh my God, Brittany, little birthday gift action. We'll have to sing happy birthday, get you a cake. I love you guys. I'll see you later, and sleep tight. Don't let the bed bugs bite. Bye. Mwah.